तो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर छाबड़ा एंड टुडे नीता प्लीज स्विच ऑफ योर वीडियो. नीता
प्लीज टर्न ऑफ योर वीडियोस एवरीवन.
सो फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव असेंबल्ड हियर टुडे ऑन जूम टू स्टार्ट विद द ट्रेनिंग ऑन ऑरिकुलर थेरेपी. फ्रेंड्स, when we talk of auricular therapy, many people you must have heard of calling auriculotherapy. I must clarify that auricular therapy and auriculotherapy are both one and same thing, so you should not be confused about the terminology about auricular therapy or auricular therapy. And I start with it. So this auricular therapy and auriculotherapy both are the same thing. And friends, why do we call it auriculotherapy? And how it differs from acupressure? Auricular therapy is also branch of acupressure. If you go back, earlier it was acupressure. People used to treat on the whole body. That used to be called acupressure. Then an era came, people started working on the foot. They believed that same points which are existing on the body are existing on the foot also. They called it reflexology. Then came the new era of Suzuk. People started believing that the points are existing on the hands, palm also. So, look, and then came the newest area that people started believing that points are existing on the ear also. Ear technically is called auricular in scientific language. Ear is called auricular, and therapy is called auricular therapy. Now you must have understood why do we call it auricular therapy? Because the technical name of ear is auricle, so therapy is auricular therapy. Friends, before we start with the real science, I must explain a little about myself. I am Dr. Chhabra. I did my BSc in 73 with medical side. Then in 76, I did MSc. Then I joined as an assistant scientist in 76. Then I did PhD and then became a scientist. Then became senior scientist, and then became the principal scientist. Friends, to your knowledge, in scientific field, there is no higher designation than principal scientist. The biggest scientist, biggest designation or in a scientific field is the principal scientist, and I was on that. Then there may be administrative line, anybody may be chosen, anyone, any even be any charge, but the biggest promotion of a scientific field is principal scientist, and I was on that. After retirement in year 2012, I started doing this. In fact, I joined this field of alternative science only in 2016. 2016, I learned acupressure initially. And then during my period of research, I must tell you, I visited about more than a dozen countries on scientific research schedule. And we used to have collaboration with different countries. Like we had a collaboration with Sweden, Denmark, Norway, USA, Australia, China, Canada. We had all collaboration with these countries. Their scientists used to come to our station, and we used to go there every year. We had to visit one country. So after entering this alternative science, I did MD in alternative medicine in 2016, then did many. I came in contact with UP Singh and Jagmohan Sadeva, and I did many therapies like acupressure, acupuncture. I tell you what therapy I do. So the name of my clinic is Dr. Chhabra's Laser. Dr. Chhabra's Laser Hair Health. The name is Dr. Chhabra Laser Health. Health, you must understand. You must be understanding because I am dealing with the auricular, so I am known to the health. But what about laser and hair? I explained you. I am giving this telephone number, mobile number, so that in case you need any help from me, you can note this telephone number. And Pooja must have already given you my own number. And I belong to Haryana state and city Hisar. This is one of the pictures where I was training people auricular therapy with UP Singh. Hall was full to capacity. There were 160 seats. Hall was full and there were people standing waiting for the seat. There were no seats. This, I was training Suzo, hall full of seat, not a single seat vacant. So, when I teach you auricular therapy, I'll be differing little from others. I'll be differing. I'll explain you 13 morphological parts on here, everybody explain. But how am I differing? I will explain in much more detail. I'll explain much more detail how to make a protocol. That will be unique feature of my training. Anatomy and physiology. Nobody you must have heard of talking of anatomy physiology when dealing with auricular therapy. I'll take one full day anatomy and physiology and one full day how to make a protocol. So last day, fifth day will be how to make a protocol. That is very important and none must skip that class. That's very important. And functional part, people must be telling this is this part, but I'll explain the very detailed function each part, which nobody else might be explaining. But why we must learn auricular therapy? Why I'm emphasizing auricular therapy? Number one, it is fastest growing auricular therapy. I'll explain in next video how it is fastest. You go back to acupressure, it was thousands of years back. And this came only 30, 40 years back, auricular therapy. And now more experts of auricular therapy than acupressure. It's much more advanced in 30, 40 years compared to acupressure, which was thousands of years back old. The results are very instant in this case. Results of auricular therapy are very instant. And relapse of disease. In many therapies, you treat a patient, patient will be treated, problem will relapse. But in this case, relapse of disease is much less compared to other therapies. And the recurring expenses are very less in this case. I'll explain what sheets are to use, how to use it. I'll explain in few minutes. And but I must tell you, just one sheet cost, just applying the whole year cost of 2, 3, 4 rupees. Just in 2, 3, 4 rupees to teach a patient, so it's not expensive as well. It's not. And number next is it is not very high time consuming. To take 10, 15 minutes to treat a patient. And one more point about the auricular therapy, there are many landmarks. There are many ridges and grooves, ups and downs in the ear. These help to act as a landmark. More the landmark, easy for us, me is to explain and easy for you to understand. So there are a lot of landmarks that help us to understand in a better way. And one more point, very big plus point with the therapy, your teeth once in a week. Acupressure, you have to work daily. You have to work daily. Patient has to work daily. So it is very tiring and cumbersome. In this case, you have to treat only once in a week. And one more thing, and excellent about auricular therapy, you treat on the ear. Hands are free. Unlike acupressure, you treat on the finger. Lady or female has to go to home, go to washroom, have to work in the kitchen, something. These magnets go into 1, 2, 3 hours. Tape gets loosened and fall down. So results are not that good compared to this therapy. In this, the seeds are applied on the ear. So your hands are free to work. Please, you keep your videos off every time I have to do. And next therapy, next important thing is, I have to switch videos, stop videos time and again, please. Hands of the patient are free. And next number is, it is a scientific therapy. This is therapy which went to the WHO, World Health Organization. Very limited therapy went to WHO. And I'll explain how it went and what was the role of WHO in this case. And there are many books. This is therapy, many books written. And of course, there is difference of opinion among the books you'll find. And I appreciate therapy where is the difference of opinion. When there is no difference of opinion, it means therapy is not that good. What about history? How it developed? How it came to us? Only in 1951, I'm not talking hundreds of years back, I'm only talking about 1951, there was a French neurologist, Paul Nogier. There was a French neurologist, Paul Nogier. He was doing cautery on the ear for some disease. And what did he find? That the sciatica pain, the pain in the leg, was away within minutes. He was unable to believe how it happened. He started on thinking. He thought that if there could be a point on the body, there could be a point in the ear. And he was correct. He was correct to some extent as well. In 1977, he gave a new approach that ear has seven many points. And he gave the concept of
please mute the
speakers off.
I waste time on this thing. I have to waste time, but time is your time is wasting, not my time.
Pooja, you have a choice to mute.
Vishal Jake Sandani. And we Vishal
I muted him.
Vishal, yeah. Video is also on. Vishal, what are you doing? Please save our time.
Yes, it's muted now.
Yeah, it's a request that you mute everyone. You have that access. And when anybody wants to talk, they can raise their.
Okay. In 1957, Paul Nogier gave a concept of inverted baby. Means what? In the ear, you assume that a baby is inverted just like in the womb.
We can't able to hear you. Muted yourself, sir.
We are not able to listen, sir. You are on mute.
Wait. I'll just call him.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, sorry. Out of 100 points, only 43 points were accepted. And I appreciate such therapy where there is some rejection. If there is no rejection, there is no improvement. Rejection brought improvement gradually. And this is the way in 2020, only it went to WHO 90 and only 30 years passed. And you know the people in auricular therapy are more than the acupressure. Why? Because results are good, results are instant, results are fast. Relapse capacity is easy. It's easy for clients to do work, easy for the therapist to work. So I'll look into all these things. The auricular therapy nowadays the top therapy of the country. This is inverted baby. What is the purpose of by showing this inverted baby here? Means he assumed that the inverted baby, suppose here is head, the points related to head will be here, here is legs, points related to leg will be here, point arm here, points later arm he will be here and likewise. So this inverted baby concept really worked. This is spine, show that there is spine problem, you have to treat this area. If there is a arm pain, you have to treat this area. If there is leg pain, you have to treat this area. So these point invert show inverted baby, you can say inverted baby. Upper thing will be on the lower side, a lower thing will be upper side because it is inverted baby. And WHO recommended many therapists to use this therapy. Who were those? Acupuncturists, chiropractic doctors, dentists, medical doctors, neuropathic doctors, nurses. There is special courses made for the nurses. And physiotherapists, psychotherapists, reflexologists. They directed such therapists to deal with the auricular therapy as well. Because Or auricular therapy is an excellent pain reliever. It's an excellent pleasure. It's a pain reliever. So before you are doing, for example, physiotherapy, give pain reliever, pain will be less. If pain will be less, the patient will be able to tolerate more and you will be able to do more better exercise.
Again, could not able to hear, sir.
Please unmute yourself.
Okay. And left ear and right ear. Okay. When to treat left ear, when to treat right ear. If you have a problem on the left side, suppose you have left knee pain, you have left shoulder pain, you have left eye pain, you have left side teeth pain, you have left ankle pain, you have left elbow pain, you have left wrist pain. If you have any problem on the left side, you treat your left ear. If you have pain on the right side, for example, if I have pain in the right eye, I have pain in the right side teeth, I have pain in the right abdomen, I have pain in the right ankle, I have pain in the right knee, then treat the right side. Right side pain, right ear teeth, left ear pain, treat left ear. And if there is, if you don't know where the pain is, centrally located pain, for example, you have a thyroid pain, thyroid problem, where you'll go, left or right, it's centrally placed, you do both the sides. If you don't know anything, whether it is left or right, treat both the things, both the ears. Okay. And for nervous pain like paralysis, if you have paralysis of right side, I'll explain about one point, but I not explain right now. I'll explain later on because you will not understand. In that case, left ear to treat for left body pain, left paralysis, you treat right ear, and for right, you have to left. But for the timing, don't confuse me that. I'll explain later on. Friends, I'm shifting to patient history. Many people can explain about the auricular therapy, but these are fundamental things you should know. How to know a patient, if a patient comes to you, first time you must spend 1 hour on the patient history. How to know the patient history? Suppose a patient has come to you, he's sitting beside you, note the name, age, mobile number, disease, symptom. Name, you must know, age is fundamental to very diseases. Suppose a girl of 15, 15, 16 comes to you for knee pain, and a lady of 60 or 70 has come to for knee pain, there is difference of treatment. You must know mobile number, you must know disease. And I recommend if you know the disease, write some indication on the mobile that this patient has this disease. Some indication. Because when sometime the same patient calls you next time, the moment he or she calls, something must come to your mind that he has this problem and I must give this treatment. You get some time to think over that and some symptom. What are the symptoms? These are the things you must ask. And few questions you must ask. For example, ask one by one system, digestive system. Are you okay from digestion point of view? Digestion is okay. Do you have constipation? Do you have loose motions? Do you get any sort of vomiting? Do you have antacid reflex point, or anything related to digestion? Ask this question. Urinary system is okay. Are you going to urine in the night time many times, or just walking the night for one time, three times, four times? Reproductive system. If a male, just ask. Don't ask direct question indirectly. You have to ask fundamental questions like reproductive system. How old are you? You are important. Don't ask this funny question like that. How old are you? He said 30, 35 years. Okay, you must be married. Okay. How much are children? Two. If he's saying two children, one children. So the question of importance is going away. Okay. How much is the difference between two both children? 10 years. Then the question must come to you. Why it became 10 years? So you must understand this point. If a lady comes to you, have you normal periods? Have two babies? What is the gap between babies? Are you conceiving normal? ask indirect question, don't ask straightforward question about the periods. Are you getting normal periods? The gap between period is how much? It is delayed or more normal, too frequent, or premenstrual syndrome. She has pain before the periods. If she's coming, if she's around age 45, 50, you may ask about the menopause as well, or sometimes menopausal symptom, you may get like hair fall, all these things. You must ask such questions also. Respiratory, she's tiring so soon, she's unable to breathe, she has frequent cold, cough, you may ask this question also. Circulatory system, she goes on the staircase, gets tired. So there is any circulatory issue like varicose veins, something like, or the high BP, these things question you must ask. And one thing, listen attentively. Note this point on your diary. First time, spend 1 hour, I am saying you. If a patient comes to you, suppose he says, I have headache pain, don't start it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 points. Sir, I told me 10 points, you start doing 10 points. It's a foolish, you'll never get results. You must know the cause. This is the difference between an allopathic doctor and you. Allopathic doctor, for you, for example, go to eye doctor, you say eye pain, he will think only of eye. He will not bother your eye pain is because of constipation, because of nervous system. They don't spend that much time. But we are supposed to spend a lot of time, and you must try to analyze what is the cause of this reason. If you are not able to find out the cause of the reason, the pain or the problem, it means you are not doing justice to the patient. Listen attentively. And I'm emphasizing the word, watch attentively. Listen and watch. A lady comes to see you, says, I have a headache. I have frequent headache. She said headache. She didn't say that she has headache in the forehead. You have to watch it. She said, I got headache. It means she has cervical, she can have cervical pain. I got pain in the pain this side. It means she has pain in temporal, the last right temporal, left temporal, both temporal. So you have to watch their feeling. How much gravity she's pain, feeling pain, her pain. She's chronic pain. How old is pain? It is just 5-10 days back or very old chronic pain, many years back. You should know whether the pain is chronic or acute. Watch feeling and expression and then make a protocol. Make a protocol, and if you have a software, you examine the protocol. If there is point missing, you can add that point. And next and last point is teeth. There are two type of problems. Number one, acute problem. Number two, chronic problem. What is acute problem? Which came just 5-10 days back. Suddenly she fell down. There's some pain. She hit it somewhere. She had a elbow pain. She played tennis. She had tennis pain last 5-7 days. These are acute problems. Tennis, chronic pain. She is a BP patient since last 10 years, 8 years, 6 years. Like she's a diabetic patient like this since last 5 years. That's chronic pain. Treat acute problem first. Chronic patient later on. Teeth, because reason, acute problem may go in 1, 2, 3 sittings, but chronic patient like a BP patient, it may take 2 months, 3 months. If you start doing first chronic pain, it will take 2, 3 months, and you will not be able to work for 2, 3 months, and the patient will not be able to come frequently to you for many sittings because it takes a lot of time. He will not gain confidence in you. If you treat acute problem first, acute problem will be away in 3 to 5 days. The patient will gain confidence in you, and you can gain confidence in the patient. So system first. So take acute problem first, chronic patient pain later. Many times I've seen, I'm emphasizing this point, listen carefully. The student learnt auricular therapy, not even the 5 days complete, 3rd or 4th day. They will start treating such a complex problem which they have heard of it. They will know name, they have seen the name in the net, and they have started treating. Please don't start treating very complex problem in the very beginning, because if there's a very big problem, if such a big doctors could not do in years, and how you could expect to work in to treat in 1 or 2 sessions? No patient will, everybody knows that you are new. They will not come to you for 2, 3 months. And if you try all new patient and tough patient, you will be discouraged. Ultimately, you will be discouraged. Your moral will go down, and you will not be able to treat. So treat simple problem first. Don't take complex problem in the very beginning. I'm repeating again and again this point. So friends, now coming to real auricular therapy. First, we explain what are the morphological parts of the ear. What are the parts? I'll explain the different parts of the ear. And if when I explain the parts, then I will explain one by one which are the different points on the part. First, you have to learn what are the different parts of the ear. Friend, this is ear. This is ear. When I explain, kindly touch your own ear. The outermost part of the ear, this out yellow color, outermost touch, can you see me? Outermost part, exactly outermost part, that is called helix. You can say this is written helix, outermost yellow part. This, please keep a watch on the cursor. This yellow part, complete yellow part from here till here, this is helix. The outer part is helix, outer border. And if just inside the helix, there is a bony structure. Can you see this part? Please. This outer was helix. At the inner, this bony structure is anterior. Can you see? Anterior. Please wait. If you don't understand it for the first time, don't make a panic. I'll make you understand before you leave it. Definitely. Everything. First what I can show you this on this also. Outer side is what a helix, outside. Outside is helix. And then inner bony structure, this blue structure, this is anti-helix. This structure, this was helix, this was the anti-helix. This is anti-helix.
Excuse me, sir.
Pardon?
I'm sorry to interfere, but I wanted to know, see, the words which you have been using, the terms, although you're trying to be clear, are not very audible. So would you be sharing some kind of PDF which you would be reading simultaneously to learn, read after?
It's already been sent. Please check the main group right now. Don't interrupt the training. The PDF has been shared, and if it has not reached you, I will resend it in the main group.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
This was helix. This is anti-helix. This is anti-helix. Anti-helix when goes up, I showed you the anti-helix when goes up, it divides into two parts. Number one, this part, and these two parts, green parts. Upper part is called superior crust, and lower part is called inferior crust. Upper part called superior crust, lower part inferior crust. I'm again repeating. This was helix. This is anti-helix. When anti-helix goes up, it divides into two parts, upper part, superior crust, lower part, inferior crust. Two legs, just like a man, inverted baby, standing with two legs. Upper part, superior crust, lower part, inferior crust. So, just to remember you, upper part, natural superior, lower means inferior. Upper is bigger, lower is smaller, say inferior. So upper is superior because it has many points. Lower is smaller, inferior because it has many few points. Just to remember you. This is called anti-helix superior crust. This is called anti-helix inferior crust. Anti-helix when goes down, there is grain outgrowth like structure, like this. Can you see me? This. This was anti-helix. This outgrowth like structure. I'll show in many ways, don't worry. And if you don't understand right now, you'll be able to understand. Anti-helix went down, there is outgrowth called antitragus. Called antitragus. And just opposite to the anti, this was antitragus. Just opposite to anti-helix tragus, there is some outgrowth called tragus. This just above the ear hole. Just above the ear hole, there is a outgrowth. Just above the ear hole, there is outgrowth that called tragus. This was antitragus, this was tragus. Between the two tragus, antitragus and tragus, there is notch. The gadda tha bana hua hai, that's called intratragic notch. Intratragic notch, this is called intertragic notch. This is called intertragic notch. Now helix when goes into the ear, now this was helix going to inside the ear, entering into the ear. It makes two cavities, upper and lower. Upper part is called simba concha, lower is called cavum concha. Upper part is called simba concha, lower is called cavum concha. And this was superior crust, this was inferior crust. Between them, there is a groove-like structure called a triangular fossa, written here. Triangular because it's triangular shape. Triangular fossa. And between the helix and anti-helix, there is a small cavity called scapha. Full name is scaphoid fossa. Sometimes we call it scaphoid fossa, and short we call it scapha. These are 13 parts. I explain again. Listen again carefully. And this is earlobe. Basically, earlobe at the bottom. This is earlobe. I repeat again. This is the earlobe. When the teacher punishes you and pulls your ear, that is that ear. That is earlobe. Okay? And this is helix. Outer boundary is called helix. Outer boundary is called helix. Just inside the helix, there is little bony structure called anti-helix. Anti-helix when goes up, divides two parts, upper superior crust, lower inferior crust. Anti-helix when goes down, there is an outgrowth called antitragus. Just in front of antitragus, there is a tragus. Just in front of antitragus, there is outgrowth called tragus. Now this is tragus. This is antitragus. Between tragus and antitragus, there is notch called intertragic notch. Intertragic notch. And helix, when goes into the ear, makes this structure called helix crust. Helix crust divides in this part, two parts, upper blue part, simba concha, and lower purple part called cavum concha. Simba concha, cavum concha. And between helix and anti-helix, there is a groove-like structure called scapha or scaphoid fossa. Again, repeating third time. This is earlobe. This is earlobe. This was helix. Just inside the helix, there is an anti-helix bony structure. Anti-helix, when goes up, divides into two parts, upper part, superior crust, lower part, inferior crust. Superior means it's upside. Inferior means lower side. Superior means more points on this. Inferior means less point on this. Superior means it's bigger. Inferior means it's small. And when antitragus comes down, makes an outgrowth called antitragus. Just opposite to antitragus is tragus. Between the two is a notch called intertragic notch. Intertragic notch. Helix when enter into the ear, it makes an outgrowth ridge-like structure called helix crust. This cavity is called simba concha. This cavity is called cavum concha. This cavity is called simba concha. This cavity is called cavum concha. And between superior crust and inferior crust, there is a triangular fossa. Triangular shape, triangular fossa. And between helix and anti-helix, there is a cavity-like structure called scapha, or full name is scaphoid fossa. I explain in other way. I explain many ways. Don't worry. Don't make a panic. Don't nothing to bother. You will not leave the class without making explain everything. This is an ear, full ear. The bottom part is earlobe. Everybody knows. Because one is given punishment through this part, earlobe. Outer part, this green, written here helix. Out part is helix. Inside the helix, there is a bony structure called anti-helix. This is helix, this is anti-helix. When anti-helix goes away, goes up, it splits into two, divides into two. Upper is called superior crust, lower is called inferior crust. Upper is called superior crust, lower is called inferior crust. When it goes down, it makes outgrowth called antitragus. Just in front of antitragus, there is another structure, the other outgrowth called tragus. Between antitragus and tragus, there is notch-like structure called intertragic notch. That's called intertragic notch. Helix, when enters into the ear, makes a crisp structure called helix crust. Above the helix crust is chimba concha, and below the helix crust is cavum concha. And between superior crust and inferior crust, there is a triangular shape called triangular fossa. And between helix and anti-helix, there is a cavity-like structure called scapha. I explained once more. This is helix. This is earlobe. You must be remembering these two parts. Earlobe at the bottom, and this is helix. Inside the helix, there is bony structure called anti-helix. When it goes up, upper is called superior, two parts, upper part is called superior crust, lower part inferior crust. Anti-helix, when it goes down, there is outgrowth-like structure, antitragus. Opposite antitragus is called tragus. Opposite antitragus is called tragus. Helix, when enters into the ear, makes a helix crust. Helix crust divides this crust into two parts, upper part chimba concha, lower part cavum concha. Between superior crust and inferior crust, there is a triangular fossa. And between helix and anti-helix, there is scapha or scaphoid fossa. I think you must have understood it. And I'll explain in many more ways. Don't worry. I'll not leave you. On the Lear model, this is helix. Under inner bony structure is called anti-helix. This is helix. This is anti-helix. And anti-helix, when goes up, divides two parts, upper part superior crust, lower part inferior crust. Upper part superior crust, lower part inferior crust. When anti-helix goes down, there is outgrowth-like structure called antitragus. Opposite the antitragus is tragus. Opposite the antitragus is tragus just on the ear hole. Between the tragus and the antitragus, there is intertragic notch. Between antitragus and tragus, there is intertragic notch. Now, helix, when enters the ear, makes helix crust. This divides into cavity in two parts, upper part chimba concha, lower part cavum concha. Antitragus, when goes up, I told you, it divides two parts, superior and inferior crust. Between these two crusts, there is a cavity-like structure called triangular fossa. And between helix and anti-helix, there is a cavity called scapha or scaphoid fossa. I think you must have understood. And I explained once more on the ear model as well. Once more. This is earlobe, lower portion earlobe. This is helix. This is helix. Inside, anti-helix. It divides in two parts, superior crust, inferior crust. Superior crust, inferior crust. When it goes down, there is an outgrowth called antitragus. Opposite the antitragus is a tragus. Between antitragus and tragus, there is an intertragic notch. Helix, when it enters into this, it makes two cavities, upper chimba concha, lower cavum concha. Upper chimba concha, this cavum concha. Antitragus, when goes up, this was superior crust, this was inferior crust. Between these two is a triangular fossa. And between rex and anti-helix is scaphoid fossa. Now tell me if anyone has still not understood you. Of course, friends, you have to remember parts. To remember part, it takes time. But I think you must have understood it clearly by now. And same thing, with you will be covering many, many, many times. Don't worry, even if you have not understood right now, you will be discussing many, many times. Don't worry. Okay. What therapies I deal with? So far, I'm talking auricular therapy. I deal with acupressure, acupuncture, auricular therapy we are discussing today, zoke therapy, cupping therapy, magnet therapy, dry needling, FDT, face diagnosis and treatment, आयुर्वेदिक एक्यूप्रेशर, कलर थेरेपी, ऑरिकुलर कलर थेरेपी, पल्स डायग्नोसिस, बॉडी क्लींजिंग, मर्मा थेरेपी. एंड फ्रेंड्स, टू यू, टू मेनी ऑफ यू इट माइट बी सरप्राइज, आई एम डीलिंग विद मेनी अदर थिंग्स ऑल्सो. आई एम डीलिंग विद लेजर हेयर रिमूवल हेयर एट माई क्लिनिक. आई एम डीलिंग विद हेयर लॉस ट्रीटमेंट. आई एम डूइंग विद हेयर रीग्रोथ इफ देयर हेयर हैज फॉलन डाउन. सो हाउ टू रीग्रो इट, हेयर विग फिक्सिंग, हेयर ट्रांसप्लांटेशन, टैटू रिमूवल, एडवांस लेजर फेशियल्स यूजिंग लेजर्स, प्लेटलेट रिच प्लाज्मा PRP, फेस लिफ्टिंग, स्लिमिंग विद लिपो लेजर, कैविटेशन, RF, वैक्यूम और प्रेशर थेरेपी, फोटो फेशियल, बोटॉक्स एंड फिलर्स. आई एम डीलिंग विद ऑल विद दीज थिंग्स. इफ यू हैव एनी इंटरेस्ट इन एनी थिंग्स, यू कैन डिस्कस विद दीज ऑल्सो. नाउ आई विल नॉट डिस्कस एनीथिंग अबाउट दैम. माई पर्पज आर टू टेल यू दैट आई डील विद दीज थेरेपीज ऑल्सो, बट यू कैन डिस्कस आफ्टर द क्लास और ऑन द व्हाट्सएप. सो देयर हाउ few things I would like to tell you before you really start your test session. Number one, Pooja has given you PDF notes. They have sent you PDF notes on your group. Kindly get it printed and keep copy in your front of you. Copy in front of you. Number two, note every point as far as possible. Note, and if you are unable to note right now, you can note later on. You will be given video. You can listen as many times you want it, and you can prepare notes. Keep index pages free, but when you make notes, keep 5-7 pages index pages, because suppose a patient comes to you for the knee pain and you have to search knee, don't put on changing pages one by one. Once you on the index your knee, your page go to 17 pages. So you go to straight to 17 pages. If you are watching every page for every point, so your impression to the patient will not be good. So you should look like a professional. As far after few days, you'll remember every part. But initially also, you must have a good index. Make a good index of 5-10 pages. Alphabetically, possibly if you have a computer, note them alphabetically so that you need not to waste time searching it. Friends, I'm trying to explain everything in many ways. I explained you one. When I was discussing morphological part, I explained on colored part. I explained on another ear. I explained on the ear model. Then I explained on this. Then I explained my own ear. Few things are easy to learn on the ear, live ear. Few things are easy to understand on ear. Few things are easy to make on chart. I'll make all of us to make you understand, but everything cannot be understood on every part. Don't make a panic. So you will understand. I will not leave you. Go back untrained, don't worry. If you have a diary or a computer, you record all the points. How to apply seeds, I'll let you know today itself, how to apply seeds, what are audicular seeds, how to apply it. And number one word, which will come across frequently, I'll use the word tender points. What are the tender points? Tender points are means, suppose you have a low back pain, and I will tell you later on, this Antilix is for low back pain. How do you draw tender point for your low back pain? When I'll move the jimmy over here, this is called jimmy, this is called auricular jimmy, 3-inch jimmy. You need to buy, and many of you must have bought it. And if you have not bought it, I'll send you address of the vendors. You can buy for anyone. To one wonder, I fixed the rate for jimmy, ear model, and auricular seeds, needle, you can buy from him. And if you find cheaper from any other source, you can buy from anywhere. They will send you through courier, nothing to bother. Pooja will mail, post you all details about the vendors, okay? So tender point, when for the low back pain, you are pressing here, at some particular point, there will be very acute, chronic, sharp pain, tearing pain. That point is chronic point. If you have caught that point, it means your problem will be solved. That point where you feel a severe pain, that is called tender point. So you have understood tender point means where you find a pain on the ear, not on the knee. For your pain in the knee, you will find a point here on the ear. The point on the ear where you find a sharp tearing pain, that is called tender point. You have to search the tender point. only then you have to apply it. You search the tender point, then you mark that point, tender point with the pen, and you apply stage, then you will get better result. And different books, different opinions, friend, in auriculotherapy, it's not different that I mark some point at some place, other book might have different place, but it is a, since this is auriculotherapy in the process of development, there may be some changes, nothing to bother, nothing to mind. So when they, any science is progressing, there could be changes in next few years. And in different books, you may find different points at different locations also. So nothing to be surprised. How will I differ from others? Anatomy and physiology, I'll try to explain as far as possible. I've kept day 4 for anatomy and physiology. No one else will teach you in auricular therapy. How to make a protocol, 5th day will be how to make a protocol. I'll explain in fullest detail. Nobody else must have trained you. Even if you are trained for anyone else, you will definitely appreciate my method of teaching, that the way I explain how to make a protocol would be wonderful. Test between, in between, I may ask the questions, especially those who put your video on, their audio on in between, I'll ask them questions. You have to alert every time. And daily you will get one protocol. After training, you will be in my group. Daily I am sending one protocol for one disease. Suppose after training, you need some protocol. Let me know. Your protocol will be waiting list. Don't expect next day. Suppose I have 5 protocols. I'll keep 5 in the waiting list. You will get one by one. Automatically, you will know this is the waiting list. Your number will be third day it will be coming. So every day, I'll send you one protocol. But sorry to say, I'll not be able to send your protocol. Suppose you demand it today, I'll not be able to go tomorrow. It may take 2-3 days. But you will get protocol. Even if you are not getting training from me, anyone of your family, any remote plus, from wherever you got the training, you ask protocol, I will provide it. And one special video every Friday. There is one video today. Today I could not post it. 5:30 it will be posted. 5:30 it will be posted right now. It is you will get at 5:30 today, and every week at 5:30 Friday you get one video, but only if you have registered my name. If you have not, then you will not get it. Okay, so you'll get one video. No serious patient in the beginning, as I have said earlier, no over expectation. Sometime, what happens? A patient comes to you, he says, I have a thyroid pain. You put 2 points, thyroid theek hua. What fun you are making. How do you expect in 2 minutes? So don't do over expectation, don't give over expectation. By doing over expectation, you are spoiling your client. We can make magic, but these are all medics are not magic every time. So every treatment is not magic. So don't overexpect, don't promise too much to the patient. No overstimulation. When you have marked a point, suppose your knee point here, you have to stimulate it. First part is to search a tender point, then you have to stimulate, just press 2, 3, 4 points. Don't overstimulate. Sometimes you stimulate so much that each patient should be treated, should not have pain right today. You overpress it. Don't overpress it. Pain may increase. I'm again repeating, don't overpress it. Don't overstimulate it. Pain may increase.
Excuse me,
and
sir.
You are asking protocol. Once you have learned therapy and you are asking protocol, you make some protocol and then ask me what is the difference. Then I'll tell you, don't just, if you get some patient from hospital, take a report of 20 pages, send to Dr. Chhabra, Dr. Sir, without watching what is the patient, without watching the protocol, without thinking without using your mind, just you'll send a page, a 30 page report to Dr. Chhabra. Dr. Chhabra is sitting idle on the road and he will watch you with this. Kindly use your mind. Whatever you can do, use your mind. Then I'll say you can improve your protocol like this. Don't just send your reports. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Sure.
Sorry to interfere, but I just pointed out the way now you were saying this was a very important point that we should not overpress. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, the pain might increase.
Mm-hmm.
And the PDF, which has been sent twice or thrice already, these important points are not mentioned there. So would we be getting a few? Because in the beginning, at least, I feel we should.
You are far, please. I have not reached and started telling you this thing. I have not started telling which are tender points, how to search it. So you are asking questions which are far away from that. You will understand it.
I think we should be very patient.
In PDF, you will not find 10 points. I'll explain. Wait. I'm coming.
No, I'm sorry. I don't mean to imply only on that point. What I'm trying to imply is, for an instance, in your PDF, you have very beautifully mentioned the anti-tragus 0.9, tragus, intertragic notch. But while in the video, you have explained, very well explained rather, I should say, again and again, that what exactly and where it is placed, correct? But howsoever, this is not written in the PDF since, and if I want to revise, it will become difficult for me.
Madam, if I make a PDF, I write everything, it will make five. There is a book, you can buy book.
Namaste. Just one second, I want to interrupt. Whoever was asking that question, see, you will be getting the recording of the training which you're getting right now. Okay. So you anyways have these recordings. So great, you will, yeah. Let's finish. Yes, sir.
I think we should take questions only in the end, please.
Yes.
I think it's otherwise it interferes.
Yes, let's not distract sir's flow. He's going to anyway give us 5-10 minutes in the end of his session. So that time you may ask.
I'll give you 30 minutes and you will not be able to ask any question because your all questions will be solved before you ask me. I'm sure.
Okay, sir. Let's continue.
Now we are going to earlobe. Now your question, your question was how to find a tender point, how to eat it. Now we are going to first earlobe. What was earlobe? First, you must know the location earlobe. Watch this clearly earlobe. Now I'll explain points on the earlobe. This is earlobe. See my cursor. Earlobe, this portion. I'll explain different parts on the earlobe. Okay? This earlobe, you should know the location. You should not be confused about it. If you are confused about location, then I'll not be able to let you know anything. This is earlobe. My cursor is moving, this earlobe, okay? And if on the ear model, this is earlobe. I'll explain what are the different points on this. What can be treated using this earlobe? Okay? So listen, friends. When you earlobe, just pull it down. Just pull it down and make a horizontal line like this. This, you can see my cursor. Pull it down, make a horizontal line just below this notch, this line one. Then line two and line three. Make three horizontal lines. Line one, line two, line three. Okay? And two vertical lines, one and one, this like this, two. Two vertical lines. Okay, I'm again repeating. Pull your earlobe. Pull your earlobe, this earlobe, make one horizontal line here, one here, one here. If you have bought model, you'll find these lines already drawn over here. One, two, three vertical lines and three horizontal lines and two vertical lines. By making this, you'll find nine boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You'll make nine boxes, nine chambers. Okay? Nine boxes, okay? And nine boxes have different parts, different functions. Listen, what are the functions? Look upon my cursor. First part is tooth. This is ear. If I fit my ear here, this is the side close to my mouth. And this is side away from my mouth. Here, I'll find this is tooth. This is tooth. Side close to my mouth is tooth. Side close to my mouth, tooth. You will watch here on the diagram, tooth, written tooth. Then second middle part in the upper row, tongue. And last point in the upper row, jaw. Tooth, tongue, jaw. You made nine boxes. First box toward the mouth is tooth. Middle tongue and away from mouth is jaw. Come to the middle line. First point is neurasthenia. Middle point is eyes. And third part is ear, internal ear. Third part is ear. And coming to the bottom line, this was anxiety point, anxious point or anxiety point. Second was tonsil. And this area, red area, is tumor specific area. Tumor specific area. And this red zone marked here, that is cheek. Gal, hamari gal, gal wala portion, this area. Cheek. Okay. I will explain it many times, don't worry. First was tooth toward the mouth. Second was tongue. And last, away from the mouth, was jaw. Tooth, tongue, jaw. Middle line, neurasthenia, eye, ear. And bottom line, anxiety point, tonsil, tumor specific area. Tooth, tongue, jaw, neurasthenia, eye, ear, anxiety point, tonsil, tumor specific area. And if I in short, TTJ, NEE, ATT. Just to remember, TTJ, T means tooth, T means tongue, J means jaw. TTJ, NE, neurasthenia, EIE, ear, neurasthenia, eye, ear. And bottom, ATT, A means anxiety point, T means tonsil, and this T means tumor specific area. I'm again repeating, TTJ, NEE, ATT. TT means, T means tooth, this T means tongue, J means jaw. TTJ, tooth, tongue, jaw. NE, neurasthenia, eye, ear. ATT, anxiety point, tonsil, tumor specific area. And there is one more method to remember it. Usually we go on, there is some trick method, don't say it's not very polished, unpolished method. You go on the train, TT comes sometime on the train, and usually it does not come. Sometime it comes. We call TT as respectful TTG. So TTG, TTG, tooth, tongue, jaw, nahi aate, N-E-E, nahi aate, A-T-T. TTG, nahi aate, usually nahi aate. So that's where to learn. TTG, T means tooth, T means tongue, J means jaw, nahi, N-E-E, nahi aate, A-T-T. Anxiety point, tonsil, tumor specific area. Anxiety point, tonsil, tumor specific area. I'm again repeating. This was lobe, ear lobe, made three horizontal lines, two vertical lines. By drawing this, we got 9 boxes. First box toward tooth. I'm again repeating this word towards mouth. There should not be confusion. There is usually a confusion. Some people cut to this side, one people cut to this side. There should be no confusion. Tooth is always toward the mouth. I put my ear here, toward the mouth. And jaw means away from this. Tooth, tongue, jaw, neurasthenia, eye, ear, anxiety points, tonsil, tumor specific area. Again repeating, tooth, tongue, jaw, TTJ, NE, ATT. TTE nahi aate, T means tooth, T means tongue, J means jaw, nahi aate, N means neurasthenia, E means eye, E means ear. Ear is internal ear. I'm emphasizing this word, internal ear. You will mind two things for one another, separate point external ear and separate point for internal ear, but this is for internal ear. Kindly note the point, this is internal ear, not external ear. This is anxiety point. This is tonsil, tumor specific point. There is one point written here, deep sleep. This is in the back side. I'll cover this point when I cover the back side of the ear. So for the time being, I'm not explaining deep sleep point. Helix 6 point, I'll not explain. This is not part of this. Helix 5, helix 4, these are not part of this. This I'll explain when their turn will come. Okay, so I'm again explaining tooth, tongue, jaw, neurasthenia, eye, ear, anxiety, tonsil, tumor specific area. Would you understand? I think this is enough to repeat. Tooth, tongue, jaw, neurasthenia, eye, ear, anxiety, tonsil, tumor specific area. And before explaining its functions, what are the functions? We take 5 minutes break. We are taking 5 minutes break. You can have anything and we are back here in 5 minutes. Okay? So friends, we are back. Are you ready now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Now we explain the different functions. Now, before I explain the different functions of different points, these points are called, technically these points are called reflex points. You should know the word. These are called reflex points, but in short we call it points. But the technical term is reflex points or tender points. Okay. What are the function of these reflex points? There are 9 reflex points I have given you. What are the function? Before explaining the function, I must emphasize the same point again. Inverted baby concept. Inverted baby concept means if baby is inverted, on the earlobe which part will come? Our head part, this part will come. Our problems related to this part will be covered in the earlobe. How is it like? For example, the tooth. Tooth means what? What problems of tooth? Just on the earlobe, you'll be able to treat many problems. Like you have tooth cavity. Yeah, like you have toothache. Like you have a sensitive tooth, too sensitive to cold or sensitive hot. You are bleeding in the gums. Or you have bad breath because of your teeth problem. Or you have swollen gums. All these problems. Even you are going for tooth extraction. Go with this treatment first and go for then extraction. Your pain will be less. So all these things can be treated by only tooth, one point, tooth point. But I am repeating, tooth cavity, toothache, sensitive tooth, bleeding gums, bad breath, swollen gums, and even you are going for tooth extraction, you can use this point, pain will be reduced. So about 6-7 diseases you can cover with this one point. Then comes to the tongue. Tongue has 2 roles. Number one, speech. If you have anything related to speech, आप तो तलाते हैं तय तक करके बोलते हैं फॉर दैट स्पीच रिलेटेड एनी इश्यू यूज दिस नंबर 2 सलाइवा योर एक्सेस सलाइवा सम टाइम पेशेंट यू फाइंड सलाइवा कमिंग फ्रॉम हियर एक्सेस सलाइवा एंड सम टाइम mouth is dry. Every time he wants water, water, water. Because mouth is dry. So in both these cases, it balances salivation, over salivation or less salivation. It maintains it. And speaking capacity, if there is speech problem like stuttering, that could be also be covered. Okay, so this is about the tongue. Then coming to jaw. Jaw, it has two jaw, upper jaw or lower jaw. Upper jaw is this and lower jaw is this. Upper jaw is below and lower jaw above. Why? Because inverted baby, upper jaw will be lower side and lower jaw will be upper side. Any problem may be upper jaw or lower jaw, the same problem will be treated. But location point, location will vary. What will be treated? Like you have infection or pain in the jaw or tooth cavity or any type of nerve root problem. RCT, root canal treatment, you are going for root canal treatment, go for this. Or tooth sensitivity to cold or hot. Tooth sensitivity to cold or hot, you need to treat jaw. Maybe upper jaw, maybe lower jaw. I'll not explain it separate. Then comes neurasthenia. Neurasthenia is a special point. It is worked in two, three ways. One, number one, as a neurasthenia point. Number two, it will work as chakra also. And number three, it will work as a space element also later on. I'll explain later on. So don't confuse for the timing. For the timing, just listen. Neurasthenia. Neurasthenia word has been taken from nerve. Anything related to nerve, you have to use neurasthenia. Aapko nerve ki koi bhi problem hai, to neurasthenia aapko use karna hai. Kaise nerve ki pain hai? Brain, koi brain or nerve related koi bhi issue ho. Jaise ki koi stress hai, anxiety hai, tension hai, fear hai, insomnia hai, phobia hai, height phobia hai, stage phobia. Height phobia, aap meri height choti hai, main kaise karun, meri zindagi bekar hogi. Stage jaante jaane pe nervous ho jayega. Anxiety ho jayegi, exam aane se pehle anxiety ho jayegi. For all these problems, you have to use this neurasthenia. Epilepsy, Parkinson, sciatica pain is nerve compression or irritability. Bina matlab bechain rahega. So you have to use this point. Or any psychosomatic case or negative thinking, you have to use neurasthenia. You have to use neurasthenia point. You understood it? I'm again repeating, any brain or nerve related issues, stress, fear, worry, depression, extreme fatigue, bina batak thakawat, kaam nahi hai, thakawat, sone ke dil kare time, or irritability, dream disturbed sleep, raat ko neend mein sapne aaye ja rahe hain, neend puri nahi ho rahi, to sare kaam kya hai, neurasthenia ka hai, nerve ka, nerve related hai, brain related hai. Then anxiety point, जिनको बिना मतलब एंजाइटी विद नो रीजन दे हैव एंजाइटी काम थोड़ा परेशान ज्यादा एंजाइटी टेंशन डिप्रेशन पेनिंग फियर अनइजीनेस अननेसेसरी फटीग इन सब प्रॉब्लम्स के लिए आपको एंजाइटी का पॉइंट देना है एंजाइटी किसी तरह की होगी एंजाइटी का पॉइंट देना है ठीक है और कोई भी साइकोसोमेटिक कोई भी इश्यू हो तो भी एंजाइटी के पॉइंट हम देंगे टॉन्सिल फिर आ गया टॉन्सिल टॉन्सिल पॉइंट एज नेम इंडिकेट नीड नॉट एक्सप्लेन इन चिल्ड्रन यू मस्ट हैव सीन वेरी फ्रिक्वेंट टॉन्सिल एंड इन टॉन्सिल यू मस्ट हैव सीन डॉक्टर्स दैट थ्रू टॉर्च वॉच द होल टॉन्सिल इज इन्फ्लेम्ड इन दैट केस यूज दिस टॉन्सिल पॉइंट एंड ऑल पेन पॉइंट इन ऑल केसेस मे बी टूथ मे बी टंग मे बी अपर जॉ द आई Use one point, I'll tell you, explain Shenmen. Suppose you have a tooth pain. Tooth point and Shenmen. Tooth pain will go away. Tongue, you have over salivation or less salivation, use tongue and Shenmen. If you are over salivation, tongue and salivation. Like eyes, you have pain in eyes and Shenmen. Shenmen point, I have not told you right now. I'll explain later on. Just for the timing, just listen. There is one point called Shenmen. Okay. And this is tonsil means in children you have must have found a common problem of tonsils very common and tonsil you have tonsil maybe asthma use this point or sometimes when you have tonsil you have difficulty in swallowing आपको चीज अंदर गले में जाएगी नहीं, आपको दर्द गले में दर्द होगा, इन इवन इन दैट केस यू कैन डू दी। एंड ट्यूमर स्पेसिफिक एरिया, ट्यूमर मीन्स देर इज एनी, तो आप बॉडी में गांठ बन जाती कई बार, ट्यूमर ऑफ डिफरेंट एनी काइंड, मे बी कार्सिनोजेनिक, मे बी मेलिग्नेंट, एनी टाइप ऑफ ट्यूमर कोई भी है, आपको ओवरी के अंदर सिस्ट बन गया वो भी ट्यूमर है, यूट्रस के अंदर कुछ स्वेलिंग हो गई वो भी ट्यूमर है, आपको एक्ने पिंपल्स निकला है वो भी ट्यूमर है, आपके ब्रेस्ट के अंदर ट्यूमर हो गया वो भी ट्यूमर है, एनी आउट ग्रोथ ऑफ एनी काइंड, एनी अबनॉर्मल आउट ग्रोथ इज कॉल्ड ट्यूमर। ट्यूमर किसी भी तरह का होगा तो आप उसको नेवल आउट ग्रोथ के, नेवल बाहर निकलाती है ये भी ट्यूमर एक तरह से, तो ऐसे केस में हम ट्यूमर स्पेसिफिक एरिया लगाते हैं। अब आगे आईज, आईज है, आई हो गए, आईज
नहीं सर, आई नहीं,
आई मिस हो गया, आई मिस आई, आई मींस एनी प्रॉब्लम विद इरिटेटेड आई, इचिंग आई, पानी आंखों में बह रहा है, या आपको थोड़ी विंड चली पानी बहने लगे सर्दियों में और आई सूखी रहती हैं आप आंखों पर, ओल्ड एज में जनरली आपने, यू मस्ट हैव सीन ओल्ड एज, एनी ओल्ड एज पेशेंट गोज टू डॉक्टर, दे विल गिव यू मेडिसिन कॉल्ड टीयर्स, देयर दैट दैट हैज मिथाइल सेलुलोज कंपाउंड, टीयर्स मींस दैट इज आर्टिफिशियल टीयर्स, because in old age when your skin dry your eyes also dry, when eye dry you find itching, just they put the tears and they feel normal, that is the methyl cellulose acts as a lubricating agent, when you are itching just use that tears, your eyes will be okay. So you have any type of problem, dry eyes, watery eyes, burning eyes, itching, irritation, cataract, if you have problem of cataract, in old age you must have heard the problem of cataract, it's a very common problem, it's a use, twitching, eye twitching, or glaucoma, or poor eyesight, any eyesight vision, vision problem, so use eyes, you get all. So then tumor specific eye area, explained it, and there is one more point here, TMJ, I didn't explain that time, TMJ in the jaw area, TMJ, temporomandibular joint, this point is a temporomandibular joint, temporomandibular, you know, सब दिस दिया अपर जा लोअर जा देर इज ए कनेक्शन हियर दे आर जॉइंट हियर एट दैट टाइम दिस समटाइम यू आर अनएबल टू ओपन योर माउथ यू आर व्हेन यू ओपन योर माउथ यू फील पेन हियर इन योर मसल्स एंड योर बोन्स हियर एट दिस जंक्शन पॉइंट एस्पेशली इन टू टाइप ऑफ केसेस दोज हू च्यू पान पान बहुत खाते हैं वो मुंह खोलते ही नहीं बोलते नहीं है तो जैम हो जाता आपका ये जो आपका जैम हो जाता है या कुछ लोग ना तो ऊंचा बोलते और ना ही कभी खुल हंसते हंसे ऐसे कर हंसेंगे वो मुंह खोलते ही नहीं है ये एरिया जैम हो जाता है तो दिस इज कॉल्ड टेम्पोरोमेंडिबुलर जॉइंट जिनका मुंह खुलने में दर्द होता है उनको यूज करना है टेम्पोरोमेंडिबुलर जॉइंट और मैंने एक बोला था आपको शैनमन यूज करेंगे उसका टेम्पोरोमेंटियम का प्रॉब्लम ठीक हो जाएगा देखो एक ईयर लोब से इतने पॉइंट ठीक हो गए कम से 20-30 प्रॉब्लम ठीक होगी आप इतने ईयर में कितने पॉइंट्स ठीक कर लेंगे आई एम अगेन रिपीटिंग टूथ टंग जॉ न्यूरोस्थेनिया आई ईयर एंजाइटी पॉइंट टॉन्सिल ट्यूमर स्पेसिफिक एरिया एक एक का फंक्शन आपको समझ में आ गए शुड आई नीड टू रिपीट इट और इट इज एनफ जस्ट आई
सो प्लीज रिपीट इट
हां जी
प्लीज रिपीट वंस आई थिंक
टूथ लाइक टूथ कैविटी tooth egg, sensitive teeth, bleeding gums, bad breath, swollen gums, and tooth extraction. You are going for tooth extraction. Tongue, like over salivation, dry mouth, speech related issue, like stuttering. Okay. Jaw, maybe upper jaw or maybe lower jaw. Any infection in the jaw or any pain in jaw, maybe tooth cavity. You are going for RCT. You are going for extraction or you are sensitive to the cold road. You need jaw person. Then neurasthenia, neurasthenia is a very complex point related to nerve-related issues, any nerve-related issue like anxiety, tension, stress, insomnia, fear, worry, depression, memory loss, loss of focus, concentration. कई बार focus नहीं बचता बच्चों में था पढ़ने लगे उठ के चले जाएंगे और कई बार focus बन गया तो concentration नहीं होता focus नहीं है concentration नहीं है epilepsy के दौरा पड़ रहा है तो भी ये point देंगे paralysis है extreme fatigue हो रहा है इरिटेबिलिटी हो रही है ड्रीम डिस्टर्ब स्लीप हो रही है रात को सपने आ रहे हैं और साइकोसोमेटिक कोई बोल रहे हैं आप ये पॉइंट लगाएंगे। फिर आ गया न्यूरोस्टेनिक का आईज, आईज का मैंने बोला है कोई प्रॉब्लम आईज की विजन, जैसे विजन रिलेटेड प्रॉब्लम है, इरिटेटेड आईज है, ड्राई आईज है, पेनफुल आईज है, एक फ्लाइज एंड फ्लोटर सुना होगा, फ्लाइज एंड फ्लोटर कई बार क्या होता है ओल्ड एज में क्या होता है आपकी आंख के आगे ऐसे लग रहा है मक्खी घूम रही है ऐसे, काल फ्लाई, दो प्रॉब्लम आती हैं, एक में होता है कि फ्लाइज घूम रही है आपके आगे काली काली कुछ आपको दिखने में प्रॉब्लम आएगी, एक फ्लोटर्स होता है, फ्लोटर्स क्या होता है आप अंधेरे वाले कमरे में जाएंगे ऐसे लग रहा है जैसे आप आंख रोटेट करेंगे तो आप साथ टॉर्च घूम रही है ऐसे आपके आगे आंख के आगे आपको लाइट दिखेगी, उसको कॉल फ्लाइज एंड फ्लोटर्स, ये ओल्ड एज की प्रॉब्लम है, बहुत कोई प्रॉब्लम सीरियस नहीं है, ये ठीक हो जाती है और धीरे धीरे कुछ हैबिट्स बन जाती हैं, बाकी ऐसी एक प्रॉब्लम उसके अंदर भी ये देते हैं, वाटरी आई, बर्निंग आई, इरिटेशन इन आई, कैटरेक्ट, ट्विचिंग, ग्लकोमा, पुअर साइट, विजन प्रॉब्लम, इन सब के लिए इसको करते हैं। इंटरनल ईयर, इंटरनल ईयर भी शायद रह गया, इंटरनल ईयर भी रह गया, इंटरनल ईयर में से आपको टीनिटस की प्रॉब्लम है, सुनने की प्रॉब्लम है या हियरिंग प्रॉब्लम और टीनिटस, टीनिटस यू अंडरस्टैंड साउंड लाइक बजिंग, आपको ऐसा लग रहा है घंटियां बज टन 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 समथिंग लाइक और हिसिंग साउंड एवरी टाइम यू गेट साउंड, आई हैव गॉट मेनी पेशेंट्स ऑफ दिस ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड, दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ नर्वस ड्राई, नर्व ड्राइनेस, योर नर्व ड्राई, सो यू गेट, यू डोंट, यू गेट सॉर्ट ऑफ हिसिंग साउंड एवरी टाइम इन ईयर, यू कैन नॉट लिसन नॉर्मल साउंड, नॉर्मल साउंड कैपेसिटी गोज डाउन बट योर डिस्टर्बेंस इन द ईयर्स रिमेन टू मच, एंड इवन दिस ईयर हेल्प्स इन बैलेंसिंग अवर बैलेंस, यू आर स्टैंडिंग ऑन टू फुट, we are standing on two foot because of balancing, we have a power above animals, animals cannot stand on two foot, we can stand on two foot because of a special brain power given and the balancing system is above the ear, if you have any problem of balancing aap lad khada rahe hain gir rahe hain hai na to aapko ear internal ear ka point bhi dena padega aapko loss of balance of any kind kis tarah bhi loss of balance vertigo chakkar aa rahe hain to bhi aapko dena padega dizziness ho rahi hai to bhi aapko dena padega और कई बार वोमिटिंग आती है तो भी इंटरनल ईयर का पॉइंट देते हैं, डिजीनेस आती है चक्कर आ रहे हैं घबराहट हो रही है तो भी इंटरनल ईयर का प्रॉब्लम दे देते हैं, और एंग्जाइटी पॉइंट, एंग्जाइटी पॉइंट मैंने बताया एंग्जाइटी टेंशन डिप्रेशन इंसोमनिया ऐसी कोई प्रॉब्लम सारी होगी तो आप ये सारे पॉइंट देंगे, और बिना बताए आपको थकावट हो रही है और बिना बताए आपको स्टेज का फोबिया हो रहा है, आपको हाइट का फोबिया है, और कहीं को आई हैव सीन मेरे पास क्लाइंट्स आते हैं हेयर रिलेटेड स्पेशली लेडीज देव हेयर लॉस देव एंग्जाइटी बिकॉज ऑफ हेयर लॉस एट देयर एंग्जाइटी टू द एक्सटेंट देव टेक मेडिकेशन, कितनी छोटी प्रॉब्लम है हेयर लॉस हो गया हो जाएगा ठीक हो जाएगा बट दे हैव सो मच एंग्जाइटी दे हैव टू गो ऑन दी एंग्जाइटी मेडिसिन, सो सम टाइम एंग्जाइटी मस्ट, आपको एग्जाम में आपको एंग्जाइटी होगा होना चाहिए भी पर लिमिट से ज्यादा एंग्जाइटी होना दैट इज नॉट डिजायरेबल, अगर एंग्जाइटी हो तो एंग्जियस पॉइंट लगाएंगे ठीक हो जाएगा, और टॉन्सिल स्नीजिंग का बता दो एक और इंग्लिश बोल दो इंग्लिश है स्नीजिंग का बता दो एक स्नीजिंग इंग्लिश में बोल दो स्नीजिंग यू नीड टू यूज नोज आई विल कम टू दैट पॉइंट स्नीजिंग स्नीजिंग आई हैव नॉट कवर्ड दिस स्नीजिंग पॉइंट देयर ऑफ कोर्स यू कैन यूज बट यू नीड टू यूज अदर पार्ट्स आल्सो नोज आल्सो I'll tell you later on, but sneezing point here, when you have a lot of sneezing, I've seen many people early in the morning, they will have sneezing 10 times, 20 times, 30 times, they will become just, they'll sit down and start sitting 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So sneezing, this is very good point for sneezing. And I'll tell you one more, few more things about sneezing. This is not enough. This is one point and there are more points to use for the sneezing. That's why I was silent because I was thinking I'll explain. That part. So sneezing also. Anxiety tonsil is a common children problem, and especially children have this problem, and even adults have problem. Your tonsil get inflamed, there is a sort of swelling, it become red. So you use this point. A tumor specific area. Now this is not a point. You have to search the area. You need to search the area where there is tender point. You cannot apply all the seeds all around. You have to search the tender point. You give me press here, one by one, and where you find a tender point, use that. Any type of tumor, carcinogenic, malignant, or any type of outgrowth, like ovary cyst, you have a, or maybe you have a breast lump, any type of lump, any type of outgrowth on the body, use this tumor specific area. I think this is enough. You must have heard enough about it, and time does not allow me to take more time than this. And few things, very rare people will tell you, when you have a health issue, certain lines appear on the ear. Certain lines appear on the ear. What is the significance of the lines? How to learn those lines? How to remember those lines? This is earlobe. This is earlobe. This is TTJNEAT. TTJNEAT. Same thing. TTJNEATT. What are the lines? Sometimes you'll find a line here, starting from here till this ear. And to remember a line depends from where they start. This was the raised BP point. I have not taught you raised BP point. But for the timing, because it has link with that, you just understand, here will come, just below the intertriging node, you'll find a point, raised BP point. One this line starts from the raised BP point and comes down to the anxious point. This is called groove of hypotension. Many grooves will be formed. This is called groove of hypotension, means low BP. Groove of hypotension. Low BP jab ho jayega, to ye line aa jayegi. Ek line, ye, this is another line. This will again start from raised BP, go to tonsil. Groove of arrhythmia. Pulse rate. When pulse rate is low. Groove of arrhythmia. Do line ho gaya. These are three lines. 1, 2, 3. These are called grooves of cerebral arteriosclerosis. Grooves of cerebral arteriosclerosis. Cerebral means brain. Arterio means arteries. Sclerosis means thickening. There is a thickening of walls of arteries inside the brain. Thickening of the walls of arteries of the brain. And sometimes if there is thickening, they lose the flexibility, and sometimes these may burst. Sometimes these may burst. You get such lines here. And how to remember it? These are originating from brainstem. I have not taught you brainstem. I'll cover my antitagus in maybe 2 days or tomorrow. Start from brainstem, and these three lines, these are grooves of cerebral arteriosclerosis. And one line here, from vision 2, I have not taught you vision 2, you'll cover internal ear. You remember internal ear. Starting from internal ear, goes to vision 2, this is groove of tinnitus. When patient has a tinnitus problem, this line may appear. Groove of tinnitus, this line may appear. This line, upper jaw, starting from upper jaw, going up, this is missing upper teeth, missing upper teeth. If upper teeth, you have extracted upper teeth, or upper teeth damaged, it's broken, or it has been extracted, you may get this line, missing of upper teeth. And this is lower teeth, two lines may appear this side, it may go to this side. This is called groove of missing lower teeth. When lower teeth is extracted, you get this line. And if wisdom teeth is removed, you get this line. This thing you will learn by experience. You watch many different ears. But if the patient does not speak, that I don't have any problem, don't unnecessarily give treatment. You have seen that patient has this. You visualize that maybe his wisdom teeth is broken, but don't give the treatment. Maybe he's not, his wisdom teeth is not broken, you start the treatment. So watch it. These are imaginary lines, may not be 100% correct, but these are the lines as per literature. I'm again repeating. This is earlobe. These are tooth, tongue, jaw, neurasthenia, eye, ear, anxiety point, tonsil tumor specific area. Okay. To remember these lines depends upon from where these originated. Where the origin? Origin is from raised BP point. From raised BP point, there are two things. Either BP will be low or high, number one, or pulse rate will be low or lower high. If the BP is low, you get this line. And if the pulse rate is low, you get this line. Both originating from the raised BP point. this point for starting from internal ear. This is guru of tinnitus. Tinnitus means you are buzzing in the ear. And this is upper jaw, missing of teeth. If your upper teeth is missing, this jaw, and if lower teeth, two lines, this and this, missing of lower teeth. And wisdom teeth is missing, you get this line. Here, these different lines depicting some disease in your body. Could you understand it? I think I don't need to repeat it. I think this is enough. Okay.
Sir, ek bar repeat kijiye, I missed something.
Okay, okay, okay. This is earlobe. There are different parts, tooth, tongue, jaw. You made 9 parts, 3 lines, horizontal lines, 2 vertical lines, made 9 chambers. First was tooth, this was tongue, this was jaw. This was neurasthenia, this was eye, this is internal ear. This is anxiety point, this is tonsil, this is tumor specific area. Total 9 points. Okay. To remember, you don't need to cram it. I'll make you some simplified method to remember it. Two lines are starting from BP. What BP can do? BP can be high or up, or pulse rate can be high or up. One is for low BP, and one is for arrhythmia, less your pulse rate. Pulse rate is low, this line. BP is low, this line. This is starting for internal ear, means you have tinnitus line. This is called groove of tinnitus. These three lines, this is called groove of cerebral arteriosclerosis. Groove of cerebral arteriosclerosis means cerebral means brain, arterial means arteries, sclerosis means thickening. Thickening in the arteries of the brain. If there is thickening, then maybe they may lose flexibility and they may burst or they may rupture anytime. Okay. This indicates loss of upper teeth. Upper teeth is missing line. And lower teeth, two lines start from lower teeth. This line indicates when lower teeth is missing. And from wisdom teeth, one start, line is drawn. This shows that wisdom teeth is missing. Wisdom teeth is broken or missing. I think it's enough. There is no line. I found the literature. There was no line given for high BP. So the moment I'll see, I'll give you. Okay, I'll add into that. I could not find any line. It's not given anywhere. Now I'll show the same points on the ear model. This is ear model. I made 3 horizontal lines, 2 vertical lines, made 9 chambers. This was tooth, tongue, jaw, neurasthenia, eye, ear, anxiety point, tonsil, and this is tumor specific area. Tooth, tongue, jaw, neurasthenia, eye, ears, anxiety point, tonsil, and this is tumor specific area. Tumor specific area, you don't need to apply all the points. I put 8-10 bindis. Don't put 8-10 bindis. Search out a point where there is a pain. Use that point. And for practice, friends, you can buy an ear model. Ear model has nothing to do with the treatment. But ear model helps to make you expertise. Ear model makes you, to help you, to make you expertise in auricular therapy. For example, you made a pro today, you think that you have a tooth pain. What point you will use? To take bindi. I have taken simple bindi from the market. These are number 8 size bindi. These are 8 size bindi, are neither too small nor too big. You two to take this model and put the bindis on this. And then you think, you watch protocol. I'll give you software later on. You can buy software. You watch the software, then find what is the difference, what points I was using, what are the given in software, why these are given in software, why I was missing this point. So you can learn it, you can practice it gradually. This model or demo will help you to understand, not to teach any. It will not help you in treatment, but it helps you to study yourself. Okay, you can buy. So this was all about. Then friends, how to teach? The problem now, I have told you many points, TTJ, NE, ATT, etc., etc., etc. What to do? How treatment should be done? There are many methods. Number one, massage. For example, your friend lives in Canada, USA, in a remote place. He has some tooth pain. Just tell him tooth pain, just with the nail press that point. Or just if they even they cannot do it, just massage this area. Massage this area, complete area. Any problem related to mouth, massage this area. I forgot to tell you one point here. I forgot to tell you, yes. Cheek area, I forgot to tell you the cheek area. What is the function of cheek area? Any problem on cheek means pimples, acne, pigmentation, dry skin, oily skin, cracked skin, inflamed skin, and eye bags, all these problems related to beauty. We call it beauty point. Anything related to beauty can be done with this cheek point. Okay? Again repeating. Pimples, acne, pigmentation, eye bags, under-eye dark circles, cracking, inflammation of the cheeks. In winter, you get cracks here. All these things can be done by using this cheek point. So the number one was massage. If you don't know much about this, your point, massage this particular area. And I'm telling you one thing, very important thing. Listen attentively. These are 13 points. 13 morphological parts, like earlobe is one. Similarly, there are 13 different morphological parts. Earlobe was meant for this area, for our face, this area. Every morphological part has application for specific area. Some is for foot, some is for hand, some is for brain, some is for face, some is for arm, some is for foot, some is for abdomen, some is for backbone. So if you know that area, massage that area. For example, if your patient has a backbone problem, I'll tell you later on, this area is for backbone. Just massage this area. You just massage this particular area. Okay, understand it? Suppose if you have any problem in the tooth, if you know the point, it's okay, you just otherwise massage. This is a crude way of treatment, not very refined method, but crude method. Number two, auricular sheath. This is the important point, how to apply auricular sheath. Of course, I'll tell you many methods, but mainly in 95% cases, we use auricular sheath. What are auricular sheaths? Friends, this is a container containing sheets. This, and inside, if you open it, these are auricular sheets. These are called auricular sheets. If you open it, you'll find this type of thing. You'll find these type of sheets. These are called auricular sheets. On one side, you'll find seed, and other side, you'll find tape. One side, seed, other side, tape. These seeds of a plant called Vaccaria plant. These are Chinese seeds. Of course, mustard seed can be used, but in India, nobody is making it. So otherwise, mustard seed are as good as Vaccaria seed, but they have their monopoly. They are selling it and we are buying it. In India, I have not heard anyone manufacturing this auricular seed. These are all Chinese. Okay. So how to apply seeds? I'll explain the complete method, how to apply it. But brief, I tell you now, I'm telling you in brief, these are seeds. Just remove a gum little with the nail, move the gum. Keep this jimmy below this seed and pull it like this. It has come up. And apply wherever you want it. Apply wherever you want it. Apply. Just press a little, not too hard. Okay, this is auricular seeds. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 60 seeds. And one full bag, 600 seeds. This costs about 130 nowadays. Rate may change, I don't say. Approximately it costs 130. So one seed costs 20 paise. So you can apply, these are called auricular seeds. Detail method I'll explain later on, but for the timing, understanding. And auricular needles, friends, these are auricular needles. You can buy these auricular needles, they are available in the market. And you open it, it come like this. These come in the packing of 10 needles per pack or 50 needles per pack. You can buy, but initially, better you buy a packing of 10 needles instead of 50. And if you open it, you take out one needle. I'll explain method later on, but you can try only here later on, but for the timing, I'm here using it here. Insert, this is needle done. You can see needle, you can see no change. So it is not painful at all. Ladies fear a lot about from the needle, but it is not painful. Okay, so this is needs. And third is, before applying seed or needle, you have to stimulate that ear. Stimulate that point. For example, you have pain here, you stimulate it here like this. You please stimulate it. You can stimulate with the jimmy. You can spray it with this jimmy, or you can stimulate with the machine. Many of you might have bought laser. There is a laser available, cost around 1,000 rupees. I don't know exact rate. There are two type model. One cost 300-400 rupees. Other cost 1,200 rupees. Those are available. But I use this machine to stimulate, because first you'll mark the point. This, and for this, I need to use this ultrasound gel. Can you see it? Ultrasound gel. Wherever I want to apply, we have to put a little gel on this particular point. For example, here I want to use it here. I'll apply gel, and this helps to detect the point as well as teach the point. If okay. Stop share. Can you see me?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Just apply. I'm applying gel. I apply gel over here, and I have reduced it. It's a little pinching like. It's pinching light. We can increase any level. We can decrease any level. Even current is coming to a finger. Also, you can see my finger trembling. So you can do simulation with this also. But this machine is exactly not available. I bought 20, 30 years back from America. This thing is available, not now, but much cheaper things are available. This was very costly. Costing about 1,000 is available in the market. You can buy that. And next was press needles. I show you press needles, friends. These are the press needles. Can you see press needle? These are press needles. These are press needles. And if you open it, you can take one, you can see like this, the press needle. You can take out one. You can remove one and take out with the help of this small needle. Can you see small needle? Can you see? This small needle. Just small needle, wherever this point, press it there. This is called small needle. And similarly, there is one more type of needle coming to market. This needle, I have not seen nowadays. I bought it from USA long back, about 20 years back. But this needle is also meant for the same purpose. You can take out one. Can you see needle? Small needle in my hand. Small needle. Sharp needle. And we can apply wherever you want. Okay. So I remove these. So you can use, these are called auricle needles. So you can buy the auricle needles also. And when I'll explain the complete method, then I'll tell you how to use. Ladies usually fear from needles. Ladies prefer sheets. Gents prefer needles. Why? Ladies, number one, ladies are fearful of the sheets. So they prefer, ladies are fearful of needles. They prefer sheets, number one. Number two, they can cover this ear with the sheets, with the hair. Gents have small hair, they cannot cover. And especially officer level person, they don't like to be asked by every person, what are you using, what are these, what is this, what is this? They may ask any questions. So just avoid this. They prefer to use needles. Needles are to be applied for 40 minutes. Just apply for 40 minutes, let the patient go, and everything is over. But sheets you apply after every 5 days, and needles you can apply after every alternate third day. I'll explain, when I explain this method, I'll explain. So these are the different methods. And number next is, suppose you are applying needle to someone. You apply needle and he is interested for better treatment. You can apply sheets of later on. Needle and sheets both. And one more thing, moxa. Few people use moxa also. Some use, I show you moxa, and even some use magnet. Many people call these seeds as magnet. I said these are bacteria seeds, but many therapists call them as a magnet for their better profession. It's your choice. You call it magnet or seed, but these are not magnets. Even there is, suppose you have 1 or 2 points, you can use the small magnets. Everybody must have seen star magnet. You can use small star magnet, use a tape over here. But this is good if you have only 1, 2, 3 points. If you have many points, it is not that good. So overall, seeds, auricle seeds or needles are used. And out of two, auricle seeds are used in 80% cases, 20% cases use needles. But the results of needles are very good if you can use it. But you can use only with enough experience. Okay. Moxa. I want to show you moxa if I is available. This is moxa. Small moxa. You can burn it. You can burn it, and of course you can give smoke, but not very frequently used. So this is moxa. So I have told you massage, auricle sheets, Akku machine, auricle needles, press needles, needles and sheets both, and magnets and moxa. So these are different methods. How to apply sheets? Now I'm coming. Actually, how to apply sheets, real method. That what I told, that was in brief. Number one, ask the patient to wash the face and ear, especially ear, with the soap or with the face wash. First step, ask the patient to wash the face or the ear, especially with the, so that there is no wax or oil on the ear. If there is waxy ear, oily ear, your sheets will remain only for 2-3 days and these will be away. So, number two, wash and sanitize your hands. Suppose I am a therapist, you are a therapist, you have washed your own hands so that you are going to use needles or sheets. So, you should be hygienic. First, wash your own hands and sanitize your hands. Then, search tender points. Suppose you are using for knee pain, your knee point here, search tender point. Next, mark tender points with the pen. You use gel pen, ball pen do not work. Gel point, you just mark this point. If better you will mark, better you will get the result. Don't trust upon your faith that I remember this point. The moment you search a tender point, better mark it. If you will mark it, you will get better result. Then stimulate it. Once you have marked it, then stimulate. Gradually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 6, 7, 8, 12, you stimulate. And then apply seeds or needle, whatever you have taken decision. And sometimes you can use two seeds. Suppose, I will explain later, there are 2 points like T10, T11. I have not told you about T10, T11. I will explain later on. But when 2 points are very close to each other, you take one tape. आपने एक टेप ले लिया, इसके ऊपर एक सीड है, आप दूसरी टेप का सीड उतारेंगे, इसके ऊपर लगा लेंगे, आपने एक ऊपर दो सीड लगा ली, देख लिया, और आपने जो नजदीक हैं, T10, T11 साथ हैं, आप यहां लगा लेंगे, तो वो आपके 2 पॉइंट लग जाएंगे, ठीक है? So, एक टेप पर यू कैन यूज टू सीड्स ऑन वन टेप इंस्टेड ऑफ वन एंड सिमिलरली प्लस नीडल्स यू कैन आल्सो यूज ऑरिकुलर नीडल्स कैन आल्सो यूज एंड डिस्पोजेबल हाउ टू डिस्पोज ऑफ नीडल्स आई हैव टोल्ड यू मेथड हाउ टू यूज सीड्स हाउ टू यूज नीडल्स नीडल्स यू फर्स्ट ट्राई ऑन योर हैंड्स हियर आप पहले ऐसे मत करना कि अभी आपने किया फर्स्ट कान पर लगाया टू ट्राई ऑन योर ओन हैंड्स ओनली देन एक्सपीरियंस And the angle in these needles, suppose you are using here, don't insert like this. As in Ghana, just points are just below the skin. Just below the skin, you just insert it. Making angle of 10-15 degree. Making an angle of 10-50 degree. Aapko aisa nahi lagana hai. Aisa nahi lagana. Just making 10-50, just parallel to skin. Go parallel to skin and insert it inside. It will be less painful and better results. And where to dispose of? Suppose you have collected many this, then suppose I made this bottle. This the purpose, whenever I use it, I don't throw it away. I put it in, open it and put in this. I keep on pulling. After 1 or 2 months, I go to some nearby laboratory and I put in the dustbin. I request them, they allow you, put it in the dustbin. Don't throw the needle out. For your own safety, safety of the family, safety of your neighbors or safety of animals. Sometimes animals eat funny things and they may eat along with your needle along with that, it may harm them. So, and number three, it's legally very, very unethical. And as per rules are very stringent. If one is caught, you will not be able to afford pay fine. It's too much fine. So you have to throw some disposable bin in the laboratory, nearby laboratory. Nobody will mind throwing such a small tube. This tube will fill in 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months. So you can throw it, okay? So keep on pulling and then dispose it after a few days. These are the vicaria seeds I told you, they are V-A-C-C-A-R-I, vicaria seeds. And one thing I would like to tell you, how we differ from allopathy. In allopathy, for example, there is a patient of thyroid. There will be two types of patient, hypothyroid, hyperthyroid. One tablet is for hypothyroid, other tablet is for the hyperthyroid. But in most of our therapies we deal with the balancing. We don't a separate treatment for low, we don't a separate treatment high. Our principle is to balance them automatically. Allopathy, to come this boy up, we need separate medicine. For this boy to come down, separate medicine. But in our therapy, most of our therapy, same, we just need balancing, naturally both will come on the same level. Could you follow my point? Dono treatment ke liye, hum balancing karte hain, lower hai to upar aa jayega, upar niche chala jayega, separate treatment nahi dete. To thyroid ka hai hamara, we have single point for thyroid, that thyroid point will balance. If the patient is hypothyroid, it will take the same point. If it is hyperthyroid, same point. So, we believe in balancing, not treating up and down, okay? And one thing I've told you earlier, every morphological part has a separate function. Every morphological part has a separate function. I've told you 13 morphological parts, like earlobe. Mainly this helps in the this face related problem. Then, for example, anti-leaks. I'll explain, don't remember it right now. For the back pain, scapha for hand pain, helix for fever infections, simba concha for urinary system, helix crus, diaphragm, round helix crus, digestion. So every part has some specific function, and the moment a patient comes to you, he speaks, that she speaks, says, I have a low back pain. Your mind must go to anti-leak. She says, I have a tooth pain. Your mind must go to earlobe. Likewise, every morphological part has some specific function. But don't, this is just for understanding. It is not as a thumb rule. You don't make a thumb rule. But in general, to remember you, to make you understand that every part has some specific function. But it is not thumb rule. It's not correct 100%. But it is correct 60, 70, 80%. Okay. Then comes anti-tragus outside. It's already 6. So we finished by this. Today we have worked on earlobe. You can ask any question. Now it's open. You can call one by one. You can raise your hand. Ask. I'll not. Don't just raise everyone's hand. One by one, you can ask any question.